Welcome, Silvia, to TVGME and this conference on standards and emerging technology. As you are from DG Grow, we would like to understand what does it stand for and what are the different activities you cover under DG Grow?
Okay, the commission is organized a little bit like a government, so it has different ministries. And DG Grow is the equivalent of a ministry of industry. Oh. The full title of DG Grow is Directorate General for Enterprise, Entrepreneurship, Internal Market, and Small and Medium Enterprise. We work with all sorts of different things. Most probably the one you're most familiar with is the CE marking. Mm-hmm. That is to say that the product complies to European regulations on products. And that's one of the things that we do. I used to work for CENELEC, which mm-hmm. are two European standardization organizations. And then I moved to the Commission about 8 years ago. And I started working in the unit that does standardization. It's called Standards for Growth. Oh. And it's a horizontal unit because we deal with standards in all fields. And my tasks are principally related to international relations and how standards can help build trust between nations, help gain access to markets, and also how they are referenced in European legislation in order to increase the growth and competitiveness for our industries.
So standards are evolving, you know, standards will keep on evolving. Whenever you deal with one country, you know, the country is also evolving, but the space of development may not be same as European countries. So how do you match these different level of growth in different countries?
Well, what we try to do is at European level, but also at the international level, of increase the awareness of standards because they can help immensely industry and other enterprises. And we also try to go directly at international level. So we'd rather encourage all third countries to work at international level rather than focus on homegrown standards. Because okay. Homegrown standards, even if you're China, you're still building a barrier to trade. And, yeah. And in Europe, we had barriers to trade up until the creation of the single market. So. We know that that is definitely not a good thing. So we do everything we can to increase the easiness of access to markets. And we do that by trying to use standards that are international.
And SESEI is one project, you know, which is helping from India and the European point of view.
Yes, basically our unit has two projects. One is SESEC, which is related to China. And the other is SESEI, which is for India, which stands for Seconded European Expert in India. So Seconded European Standardization Expert in India. And it is the third reiteration of the project. So it's something that started about 7 years ago.
Oh, okay.
And we think that it gives really an added value. Because we could advise India in a lot of telecom activities, so TSDSI yeah. is basically the mirror of our European organization, ETSI. And we are also fostering cooperation on standardization between India and the EU. And when and if the free trade agreement negotiation will restart, definitely standardization and the role of our expert here will be definitely valuable.
I can say that, you know, if you have the standards, common standards, then it actually reduces the barrier to the trade.
Absolutely, absolutely. Standards are a tool to eliminate barriers to trade. Because, of course, if a producer can produce to the same standard, so the piece of paper has the same size in India and the EU, he just has to increase his production to sell in both markets. And that is valid both ways. It's valid for Indian manufacturers yeah. and for European manufacturers. So it's a win-win situation.
So how do you reach out to the manufacturers? Is it through the bodies, local bodies, or there is a direct access?
In Europe, we have a very good network of associations. Mm-hmm. So there are European Association of National Association of European Member States. Mm-hmm. So usually, as Commission, we reach out to the European level association, because then they will sort of make a trickle down all the information that they receive from us. And also we are trying to involve very much small and medium enterprises, as we do with consumers, trade unions and environmentalists, because we think that a standard has to be made with the consensual participation of all the parties involved, because not only industry, not only the big industry will use the standard, but the consumers will be impacted, the environment will be impacted, and small and medium enterprises form about 99% of all enterprises in Europe. So obviously we cannot not count them, because they are they are essential.
Quite true. In terms of, you know, the interrelationship with different organizations, for example, EFTA. So how's the relationship, you know, between EFTA, or how does it work? The EFTA works separately, or you work in tandem with them?
With EFTA, we usually work in cooperation, very close cooperation. For certain things, the EFTA countries have different way of cooperating with the European Union. Mm-hmm. For example, Switzerland has a very complicated network of mutual recognition agreement, mm-hmm. for which Switzerland, every time that there is a new piece of European legislation, Switzerland will adopt it as national legislation, and then an addendum to the mutual recognition agreement will have to be done. Other countries like Norway, they simply accept the European legislation, and mm-hmm. they have quite a comprehensive agreement with the European Union, and they have accepted, in order to be part of the single market, they also have accepted the free movement of citizens, free movement of capitals. Mm-hmm. As you know, the European Union is founded of four freedoms,
right.
And this is freedom of movement for goods, for people, for capital, and for services.
Yeah.
So Norway has accepted all that, and the cooperation is very good. And the other two countries are Liechtenstein and Iceland, which also adopt and use European legislation. So with EFTA, I would say it's a very trusted partner, and actually in standardization, EFTA countries are full member of CENELEC as European countries.
Okay. That's great. You know, I think you people are doing a good job, because bringing the world together, and standards will certainly, you know, create a common language.
Absolutely.
You know, between two countries or amongst the different countries.
Yeah. And you probably heard that we just finished agreements with Japan, with Singapore, with Mexico. It was just announced a couple of days ago. So our strategy against some other powers in the world is actually to open even more to the rest of the world rather than closing.
Yeah, that's great. Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.